Assalamu alaikum dear students, let's continue the topic optics. In the last lecture we have seen total internal reflection. The concept of total internal reflection was like when a source of light is placed in a denser medium and when you take various rays of light incident on the surface of a denser medium, so we had taken various rays of light. You will come to know that whenever the ray of light incident from the denser medium to the surface of a denser medium at a critical angle, the ray of light will come along the surface of the denser medium. It means what? The angle of refraction will be 90 degrees. For the angle of incidence which are less than the critical angle, the refracted ray will move as it is, but for the critical angle, refracted ray come along, it will just graze the surface of a liquid or surface of a denser medium and the angle of refraction will be 90 degrees. Similarly, we have taken another consecutive ray for which the angle of incidence in a denser medium is greater than critical angle, then you'll come to know that this time the angle of refraction will be more than 90 degrees, and refracted ray will be totally internally refracted inside the medium. Though it is a refracted ray, but since it is coming back in the same medium, so it appears like a reflected ray. That is why this process is called as total internal reflection. This we have seen in the last lecture. And what was the definition of it? Whenever a ray of light passes from a denser medium to a rarer medium, if the angle of incidence in the denser medium is greater than critical angle, then light ray will be totally internally reflected. No light ray will move outside the denser medium. This was the concept. Now, today we are going to study the application of total internal reflection, which is very important. Let's see the first application. Only first application is there. Rest of the application is omitted. Optical fiber. What is optical fiber? Students, you might have seen such type of fibers. Just see how does it glow. See, you all can see the bright spot is there only at the tip of this fiber, and rest of the fiber no light ray is emitted here. So you might have seen this type of decorative instrument used for the decoration purpose in house. So what is the basic concept over here? Let us see. Obviously, total internal reflection process is used over here, and this was not the optical fiber. This was just a simple thing which we are using for the decoration. Optical fiber, main function of the optical fiber is there in telecommunication. What is telecommunication? Transfer of audio signal and video signal from the source to the destination is called as telecommunication. You might have seen your mobile phone, how your voice signals are being communicated from one mobile phone to another mobile phone. Obviously, the waves which are emitted from your mobile phone, it will go to the network station. Then network station will enhance the power of those signal and it will again send back to the destination, means to the destination mobile phone. So what is done at the network station? Optical fibers are used. We will see its application, but let us see what is optical fiber and what is the main functioning or how does it work. Optical fiber is nothing but the bunch of thin fibers. This is one thin fiber and it's a bunch of this thin fiber. See here. And each of this fiber is made up of a transparent medium. It is a combination of two transparent medium which are having a different refractive indices. And you can say that this is a fiber or this is a pipe through which light can easily flow. There will not be any leakage in the light. As you all know, whenever water flows from the pipe, there is no leakage from one point to another point whenever the till the water flows inside the pipe. So here also it is a pipe which is used to flow a light. Light can easily flow through this pipe, and this pipe is doubly coated. The inner material of this, if you take the transverse section of this fiber, we will get the circle. Its inner pipe. This inner pipe is called as core. As you can see here. See, this is the optical fiber. This inner wire is called as flexible transparent core. Then it is coated with the another transparent medium, which is so this core is coated with another cable called as cladding. It is coated with a jacket or another denser medium which is having a refractive index less than, refractive index of cladding is less than refractive index of core. Or you can say that the core of the optical fiber is more dense as compared to the cladding. Here it is coated, and this cladding is further coated with the buffer jacket just to prevent it from damage. So it is a pipe through which light flows. Let us see how does the light flow through this such pipes. Here we have taken the pipe. Remember that refractive index of the cladding is less than the refractive index of core, means this core material is highly dense as compared to the cladding. So whenever any light ray incident over here, let us consider a single light ray incident on the surface of core. So let's see what happened at this particular point. Since it is incident on the surface of a core, core is optically denser and cladding is optically rarer. So light can easily pass from core to cladding. But if the angle of incidence over here, you'll have to set this angle of incidence at the critical angle. If the light ray is incident at the critical angle, then you will know that this light ray is not going to transfer through the cladding. It will be simply internally reflected back. And it is further incident on the surface of the core. Again, the angle of incidence will be greater than the critical angle. So it will be internally reflected back. So the same light ray will go on moving with the multiple process of internal refraction, and finally it will emerges out from the fiber. So this is just because of the total internal reflection. This entire light ray is passing through the fiber without any leakage to the core, without any leakage to the cladding, means no light ray moved towards the cladding. Only at the end point of the fiber you are going to get the light signal. No light ray will be coming out, no leakage from this point and that point. So this is the main function of the optical fiber, means here you'll have to see the internal reflection process as the base, total internal reflection process as the base of this optical fiber. And what do we mean by passing this light ray from one point to another point? We all know that when we communicate our sound signal, when it carries by the electromagnetic waves, our sound signal is carried by the electromagnetic wave. These waves are called as carrier wave. So whenever our sound signal carried by the electromagnetic wave, this sound signal is having a very low velocity, 340 meter per second. So it cannot reach to directly to the destination because with such smallest speed. So it is sent with the speed of light on the electromagnetic wave. Electromagnetic wave travels with the speed of light 3×10⁸ meter per second. So anything can reach to the destination instantaneously as a light ray instantly reaches to us. So these sound signal while moving from one mobile phone to another mobile phone, or you can say from source to destination, this sound signal may be possible that the energy of this sound signal becomes low. So in order to enhance the energy of this sound signal, we are using this optical fiber. Initially, this sound signal is converted into light with the help of a device called as transducer. This transducer then convert this light energy, this transducer convert this sound energy into a light energy, and this light energy then passes through the optical fiber, which suffers from multiple internal refraction. This signal will regain its original physical condition. There will be no loss in the sound signal whenever it passes through the optical fiber, and at the end of the optical fiber, another transducer is used. This transducer is used to convert light energy into sound energy. The device which converts one form of energy to another form is called as transducer. So at the end point also we'll have to connect this transducer. That transducer will regain the original condition of the sound signal, and that sound signal will again be transferred to the electromagnetic wave, and that signal will be carried to the destination mobile phone. This is the process of the optical fiber. This is the functioning of the optical fiber that is basically used for telecommunication. So let us quickly see what are the advantages of this optical fiber. See, the very first one, Broad bandwidth means one optical fiber can carry 90,000 signal or 90,000 channel. Such a broad bandwidth it has. This is the range of frequencies. You can transfer this many frequencies through only a single cable of the optical fiber. Then the second point is low attenuation loss. As you all know that there will be no loss of the sound signal or the any in, instead of sound signal, if you are sending your video signal, there will be no loss throughout the optical fiber, as there is no leakage of light rays from any point. Now the third point, immune to electromagnetic wave interference, means this light ray, obviously optical fiber is covered with the buffer jacket. This buffer jacket will not let any electromagnetic wave to interrupt our signal. Then the fourth one, electrically insulator. So this fiber is basically made up of glass, quartz and any other type of denser medium which are basically insulator. They are not, means no electrical wire will affect the functioning of this optical fiber. So they are electrically insulator. Then next one is theft prevention. Electrical wires basically use inner copper core. The cable which we are using for our electricity, it basic core is made up of copper. So anyone can steal this copper, can steal this wire and sell this copper inside. So you need to protect the electrical wire because it is having a main metal in it called as copper. But here optical fiber is not made up of such heavy metal and such costly metal, so there is no chance of being stealed. So that is why theft prevention is also there. Then security of information, as I told you, that there is no leakage or point inside the optical fiber, so your message will not be passed through the another fiber which are connected with each other. So there is a security of information. Now let's see the one example based on the total internal reflection. This is the example number 9.5 of your textbook. See, there is a tiny LED bulb at the center of the bottom of a cylindrical vessel of diameter 6 cm. What is given in the question? There is one cylindrical vessel, as it is shown in the diagram. One cylindrical vessel is there. It is having a diameter of 6 cm. Diameter is 6 cm. One information is given. It means what? Midpoint. When you are taking the midpoint of it, it will come exactly at the 3 cm. Then what else is given in the question? Height of the vessel is 4 cm. This is 6 cm and its height is 4 cm. The beaker is completely filled with an optically dense liquid. This beaker is completely filled with the denser medium. You can consider any type of denser medium. You can consider it as water. You can consider it as any oil which is dense. So it is filled with the denser medium. The bulb is visible from any inclined position. Obviously, let us see, one LED bulb is placed at the middle of this vessel, means at the distance of 3 cm. So this bulb will be visible, light ray can, there will be various light ray and image emerging from the source and emitting out of the denser medium. So you can see this bulb from any position. So the bulb is visible from any inclined position, but just visible, but it is just visible if seen along the edge of the beaker. When you see it through the edge of this beaker, when you see it, it is just visible. So determine the refractive index of a liquid. So what we will do over here, we will take two rays of light. This is any general ray of light emerging from the source O, incident at an angle, at any angle, and it will be reflected back. So this is any position of the bulb from where you can see. But what is the another position? It is just visible from the edge. It means what? It is given here, one hint is given that this angle of incidence, another ray that we are going to take from which that will be refracted through the edge, that angle of incidence is a critical angle because the light ray is along the edge of the vessel. So angle of refraction will be 90 degrees for this. 4 cm is the height given. Position of this source of light from the edge of the vessel is 3 cm because its total diameter is of 6 cm. So you can see this ray of light, this is again a right angle triangle, and when you calculate the ray, this incident ray, this diagonal of this triangle, you'll come to know when one side is of 3 cm, when other side is of 4 cm, its diagonal will come out to be 5 cm by Pythagoras theorem. You can easily calculate it out. So this ray of light is of 5 cm. So we can write from this the ray which is incident at the critical angle, you can write down the value of tan of IC is equal to 3/4. Tan IC is nothing but opposite upon adjacent. It is 3/4. Similarly, sin IC, can you determine the sin IC? It is opposite upon hypotenuse. Opposite side is 3 and hypotenuse is 5. So sin IC can be written as 3/5. Then from the formula of critical angle, or you can write down the formula of refractive index. Refractive index will have the formula sin r upon sin r, because here the light ray passes from denser medium to rarer medium. So sin r upon sin I. So sin r is 90, r is 90, and sin ic will be there. Sin 90 is 1. Sin 90 is 1. So refractive index n is equal to 1 upon sin of ic. Refractive index is 1 upon sin of IC. But sin IC, just now we have seen sin IC is 3/5. So refractive index will have the value 5/3, as it is a reciprocal of sin of IC. So this was quite simple example. You can do it. So hope you will have understood the topic. Thank you.